and
what about running someone like a Lone Druid? Does Lone Druid fare well up against an Alchemist? Yeah. And you wouldn't put MP, like, you wouldn't feel confident enough switching MP and mid one in lanes? Okay.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, he was.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah. Mass amounts of push which Alliance don't have D push against. No way to get rid of it. Your acid spray up and that's probably the greatest thing you've got. Wave of Terror to pull the wave off, but if it's a Lone Druid and Terrorblade together, like, what stops Team Secret from just pushing forward and taking towers?
ten seconds remaining.
Hmm?
5 seconds remaining. Prepare for battle.
Yeah, and we know that by him having the PMS and, okay, I'm just gonna switch this very, very quickly while we're watching here, and everyone on the mainstream who may have just joined us can also watch us do this. For some reason, I think Owen has gone in and changed this. That is not allowed to be changed. Oh, that's so much better. So much better. Sorry, I don't have all my observer things in place. Well, they're probably going to give the earlier one to EGM, right? Up on top, so we can get the bottle. Mm.
30 seconds to battle.
Should know, too, the fact that EGM, like... Because I was wondering if you're trying to attempt to do, like, what we've seen from Pylai Dai, this early Iron Talon, and then just stack and flash farm. Obviously, they have an Alchemist on their team, so he's probably going to be looking for that as well. But it's just this burst levels the AI has been able to take out of the jungle.
The battle begins.
Looks to be the plan. So, let's get our laning phase underway. And see how they roll out. So, Unison Farm versus MP on the Lone Druid. Puppy will be down there on the bottom lane as well. And Puppy gets a freebie as well. He just was able to find the Observer Ward with a sentry. So, we'll even free up the camp before the 30-second mark. Nice little plus for him. Paladai and mid one together up against Limp in the mid. He's got a little bit of help from EGM, but EGM's primary job is still going to have to be to, one, babysit at the very, very start, but two, move back and continue the stacks. Now towards the top lane, it is Keizu on the off lane as the Omni Knight up against Lotus, Lifestealer, and... with Boots and Sprint, he'll do a pretty damn good job for it.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Ah, he gets both. Absolutely perfect. It's alright, relax. We have Rob running around making sure we sound perfect. Obviously not. Bit of a problem. Top lane, Keizu. He's actually dropping pretty damn low. Lanskin doesn't have another stun available, and Purification is also there. But Omni Knight just wanting to burn the salve, and obviously not the last bit of mana that he has available. Might force some kind of movement up, because right now Omni Knight's... I suppose he's getting levels. So it's not that bad for him on this offlane. Yeah, so everyone right now just trying to scramble for whatever they can find in the lanes. any kind of farm. Pylite Dive being a pain in the butt to limp once again, but EGM is here, and while EGM is here with bottle charges, this is more burning of harassment than anything else. And in fact, battling through the acid spray is not working out that great for Team Secret. Pylite cops a hell of a lot of damage. But mid one is staying on top of the CS against Limp. Yeah, right now it's like he just doesn't want to leave the lane for the moment. There's still a lot of farm. The creep wave's pushing in towards his town, so it's completely understandable.
Maybe when you're older.
Alright, so what's the real timing we're looking for here? Like, everyone's taking their farm. What changes the laning phase? We've seen a little bit of rotations. Are we waiting for an item? Are we waiting for a level? Good money. But he may lose his life for it, however. He really committed in for that, no battery assault available. Puppy right behind him, but his movement speed with the boots and then the cogs pushing him back.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Wow. Damage into Mip. That's going to be first blood. He ignited most of the work, but with that long range attack that comes out of Metamorphosis, it was enough to put the IO down.
Invisibility.
This will actually mean, with the bounty disappearing to do the farming as well as the bounty rune, mid one will get some good damage onto this mid tower. Won't be enough to bring it down, but at least it's enough that when he triggers Metamorphosis again, if they do find a kill, they'll have a chance to pick it off.
Small feats hang, great ones prosper.
An invis puppy rotating down the bottom lane. He's not going to find what he's looking for because Unison Farm's moving over for what I assume is a hopeful attempt at a bounty rune. Unless he thinks he can find another gank elsewhere, but the Radiant Observer Ward discounted him moving. So mid one is very aware of what's happening and just moves to the northern side of the mid lane. Kenji's had a really good time up on this top lane. He's got the same amount of net worth as a Clockwork who was able to kill off a bear. But it's also the amount of experience. Like, you're saying neck and neck with him up against what is a 1-on-2 lane. There's a lot of farm there. The Observer Ward just got dewarded. It was a bit of a search mission from Puppy as well as Pylite Eye, so they know exactly what's going on, and this has to be a point of contention. They can't let Alchemist take the huge amount of stacks that have been prepared by Alliance.
We'll take that.
A level 3 Metamorphosis? Yeah, they're bringing almost everybody. The only one who's not coming is Lone Druid. And he can probably take the T1 tower anyway. Mid one, yep, he triggers up Metamorphosis. EGM is there, now Limp will come over, and the TPs are coming. They're going to contest the money if they can hold on to it. Keizu still has Guardian Angel. He'll trigger it up now. They're inside the Aspray in mid one. What's he actually got? Has he got enough damage with a Reflect? Lotus not looking healthy with a hookshot forward from Innocent Farm. Mid one's dropping down quickly. He has no Sunder. He has no life. Unison Farm will take the kill. Mid one goes down. Everybody from Alliance rotated over. And even MP came in. He didn't finish up the bottom tower. He's now chipping into the mid. But Alchemist is forced to stay up here and finish up the stacks. Pilot A, battery assault. Did it actually get scouted? Like, didn't he throw it down underneath them? Did they actually take some of the camps? Well, Poppy's taking the space now on bottom lane after Lone Druid rotated towards the mid. And that's that chip damage we're talking about. Bringing the tower down low, but not within deny range. Akezu's able to hold the mid lane, and they push mid one to the top. So it's another 43 seconds before he's got the metamorphosis back up again. So that's a long time before he can add pressure. Poppy, a lot of pressure on him, gets locked inside the cogs, and that's one very dead slaughter. Already is with sprint on, so he's going to take that bonus damage.
Dire structures are fortified. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Yep. And notice where they're moving. They're moving north. I'm wondering if this is also, like, once they try and take out that top tower, they're able to... It should be fine. Savage roll. Great ability. Balanced. But by taking up this, they're going to start controlling Alliance's jungle. And in return, Alchemist's farm area. And they're not mucking around.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Can they push hard enough for the tier 2? I don't know if they can take it.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
With Bloodlust, they might be able to just have enough damage to take it. They're rotating down, and already you can see mid one TPing out, headed towards the mid where there's farm. Yes, the farm's looking for another hook if he can get it. Right now, Poppy just wants his level 6. He wants to bring amplification to the fight. If he can get the farm for his Blink Dagger as well, then that's obviously going to be great. But this will come as Team Secret group up next Metamorphosis and force down another tower. MP, however, is not scared to venture out against EGM. The tether over, but it's not going to save his life. The bear didn't even get an entangle, but it doesn't matter. MP just hits like a truck. Came in with Bloodlust on, the phase boost for the movement speed. No way for EGM to get out. And no one to tether to, because Unison Farm just bailed to go and pick up the bounty runes. Are they really ready to fight, though? Like, I'm looking up towards Loda. He's building into his armlet now, but he went for this first item, Hand of Midas. I know it's the Loda special, but does this not delay you a little bit too much?
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Hook shot, perfect, right on the money. Hits Keizu, he'll repel up. He's still got purification available as well. Has to cut his way through the cogs first, and then Savage Roar will create just a little bit of space. It's a low cooldown timer. Seems more like safety than anything else. Even if he felt like he was burning too much mana, it's not that much. And yeah, the arcane boost from Omni Knight. There's your rotation from Hanskin, so VS is now going to be on the bottom lane with her swap. And Yusufarm's just there to keep the creep wave at bay. And then feed some cogs as well. And VS able to find the illusion rune. Metamorphosis, there is the fortification. Just making this a little bit more difficult for Secret to finish the job quickly. And if they really want to come in, Loda can be relocated in. But right now, there is no opportunity. And there it goes. And Lona's going to beat into the top tower. Remember, no blight stones, so no negative armor for the tower. And each time Team Secret defend this tier 1 tower, they don't just let it go. They might have a little bit of trouble doing that because mid 1 is now isolated. The relocate is on the way. Lona and EGM will arrive, and it is Lona who gets the paw swipe in. At the same time, the T1 tower will be denied up on top, and no one else is really coming to help this out. In fact, it's Pylai Dai who's trapped in the tree line. Io went back up all by his little lonesome, and Pylai Dai will have to die for no real cause on the bottom lane. If they finish him. That's if they finish him. Concoction? Really? Okay, Lim's gonna stun himself because Loda just force swiped it.
Radiant structures are fortified. Dire's top tower is under attack.
It's not too shabby. It's not as fast as we've seen some of the alchemists achieve it, even with the armlet. Yeah. They committed a four-man movement up to it, yeah. Yeah, well, yeah, Lone Druid came, but he was a little too late to the party. But the rotation did happen. But with that, does that still spell advantage in the fights? Now you get the Blink Dagger over on Puppy, so you get the aggression that comes out from him. Mid one is rapidly approaching his Manta style.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
I'm wondering if they're even thinking about split pushing, if it's not just a race. How much damage can you do before Alliance have to fall back? So where's the vision? Like, it's just, okay, no wraparound on the shrine, but they don't see anybody coming in from the tier 3s. Do you bail out now? The top tier 2 tower was hardly touched, so if they want to move, they can either be straight towards the mid where the tier 2 tower, because no one's stopping this movement from Team Secret yet. And then you get the entangle, so Loda still has to stay exactly where he is. And there's your relocate for the double crush from Puppy. Amplification on the IO. EGM is dropping quickly, but he's got the distance away, blocked out by the cogs, but Limp was locked down, unwillingly standing there. You got an extra entangle, actually. Hits on EGM, so he'll tick out when he relocates away to safety, at least what he thought was safety. And then mid one doing the job onto Hanskin in the mid lane. Now they can push that tier 2 tower pretty unobstructed. Huge fight. And in fact, they're not even going for the tier 2 tower in mid. They're knocking on Roshan.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Well, when he's a metamorphosis? I would assume dark spirit. Well, okay, we'll have to wait 72 seconds for it. And when he commits. He'll do it like Goku, man. He's taking his internal energy. That's why it takes so long to build up the eternal energy. He's sucking it from the world of Dota. Mid one's in trouble, locked inside the cogs, and with a relocate in, okay. They really wanted that kill. And they got it.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
He was on bottom. I was wondering exactly where Aya was coming back, and Team Secret knew. They're a three-man group waiting for him. Seems to be. As Limp continues his farming spree. Yeah. It's because it's still about the numbers, right? Like, it's having the overwhelming numbers that the Lions can't deal with. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So Manda is more of a, I need to make sure my pushes work after I get this to then get the money, as opposed to surviving to get the money. Alright, there's mid one. No one's attacking him, so we can have a look. We need him to attack a neutral camp. Oh, I'm fairly certain it comes from his arms. Okay, now we just smoked up. And the illusions aren't... Oh, come on, mid one! We're running experiments here. During the middle of a grand final. Good opening. Puppy, Blink, Crush. They infested in quickly, so at least he dodged the extra one. But Unison Farm, hook over. This doesn't work. Yeah, it doesn't work. I got this, bro. There you go. So what is it? It comes from his paw. Yeah, he's throwing energy sprites. Oh, yeah. Open wounds. Bear doesn't survive long up against that. Yeah, they're focusing more on the buildings now. Take out the tier 2 tower. It may also just be safer, right? Like, you take out the towers, you then establish vision around the Alliance base. So you know when they're going to come out, so you can back out from Roshan if you want to. Alliance actually burned a smoke, and they're walking into the pit. They realize no one's here, and they're going to attempt it themselves. But the ping, it came so quickly. Yeah. It's so quick. They're coming in, but the culture of Unison Farm is the perfect block! And Alliance now just want to get out of here. You've got the quick reflect, EGM, able to tether up to the hill, but it's not so happy for Hanskin. Limpson wants to be part of the fight, but he's amplified up. He doesn't have Chemical Rage for this fight, so it's all up to Loda to do the damage and to keep Team Secret away, but then Loda gets entangled. The hookshot is on the back lines, but the Sunder, the life has been split. Loda will fall inside the river as well. Unison Farm will join the list of the dead on the wall as Alliance lose 3. They may have taken Roshan. It is 4. Do they have to force buybacks now? Because they're going to lose tier 3 tower mid. Yeah, Metamorphosis is now up. Chemical Rage is not available. It's wearing out now. And he didn't have it during the entire engagement either. So Acid Spray is slowing the push. They lose the bear for the second time. But MP is still strong. He's now got a fresh bear up and running. They trigger off the shrine, so Limp has a little bit more life to survive. The concoction flies forward. It's going to hit onto MP. Hanskin not really in range for the swap just yet. And Limp, who does he really want? He has the Aegis Immortal. MP, he can't die now. He only just summoned up the fresh bear and gets caught out by Unison Farm, who TP'd out to the shrine. An unstoppable streak has been ended by... Wait, was that... Yeah, ended by Unison Farm. It was his. So Unison Farm gets a crap ton of money for his 4-star. And Alliance will counter push down the mid.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
No sorcery.
Yep. The puppy can slow it with Crush. There's a relocate coming in. So EGM's going to join the front lines, give a little bit of extra regeneration. Fortification's going to make that difficult as Limp has to toggle himself slightly through the tower attacks, and they back out. Should it really be the mid? Like, they've already taken melee racks, they can just go for shrines now. Yeah, just look at it. Now they'll do it. It just makes sense, like they tried to fall out before or after they took the objective. Like, they still got the objective they wanted. The issue is the fact that they could have someone TP in behind them, and if the next port of call is going to be the top lane, they won't care about the bottom shrine. It's just this one shrine to allow Alliance to potentially flank them quickly.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
The T1 tower will help him there. In fact, it's going to get him there. He now has the money, can buy the full Manta. The courier's already on the way. It looks like also Loda. He's got the Javelin over on the Courier, so he's tossing up. How much surplus has he got? Okay, only barely enough, but it's not enough to buy the Basher. But he'll have buyback if Team Secret wanted to force the issue. No? Oh, it's in his stash. I thought it was in... I was reading his quick buy. There we go. He has the Basher. I was actually looking at mid one, because I thought he'd build into something big like a Skadi, and okay, now he's actually switched himself over to the Skadi. Originally, he was looking at Diffusal Blade, was in his quick buy. But his money is rising so quickly that it seems to be easy enough just to go in for the full Skadi. And MP's adding pressure on the bottom lane. He could do this solo if he wants to. Yeah, and with Unison Farm? Yeah, it's the lifestealer. The issue is he needs vision. This is the vision he's currently got, so the rocket flies out, but doesn't see Pilot Eye and it sees Keizu way too late. Yeah. The money just spills out. Like, what's the, like, their advantage is still only 3,000 gold advantage. Obviously, a large amount of that money for Alliance is sitting inside the Alchemist, as he's at 19,000 net worth. Team Secret, Blink, Crush Ball, they found the Vengeful Spirit, and they've killed the Vengeful Spirit. Loda also burnt his Roar, his Rage, and the player, no, it's down too far. They have to call it back up into a fighting position. As long as it stops taking damage, yeah, he'll come back out. So there's both supports down. Unison Farm? He's trying to stay close enough for the tether. Not possible. If Unison Farmer's being that aggressive, you have to assume the lifesteal is inside. They gotta be a lot more confident going into the next fight too, like mid one with a full Skadi up and the double Hurricane Planks. And even then you got the Mjolnir fully finished over on Lone Druid. It's not gonna be terrific if he loses his bear right now on the sides, and that's exactly what Alliance is looking to do. Three paw swipes, and actually they give the last little hit into Limp. So extra cash for him and looking to get very close towards that Octarine on the Alchemist. Yep. It's the older build of the Alchemist, the one we've been more used to in the past. Here comes the push from Team Secret. Limp is here to defend it. Metamorphosis, 16 seconds away. So a little bit longer to wait. Thanks to our Observer Ward, they do know that Unison Farm was coming back, but it's not gonna be an opportunity for a kill. Poppy's looking for it, he'll find Loader, but no one else is close enough to him. But now they have it. The Observer Ward, it pays dividends. Unison Farm came back over again. That's a huge one. 46 seconds without the clockwork. A window has been opened. Yep. This should be bottom racks unless Alliance can achieve something absolutely amazing. Puppy already jumps in, gets a stun on the Alchemist, he's losing life quickly. The stun is on Terrorblade. Remember, he's still got the Sunder available, plus the GA. Keizu keeping everyone alive. Mid one still dropping down low. Limp gotta be careful. There goes that Sunder. Manta and then dodge out. Everyone wants to bail. The buyback was forced, I believe. Yes, it was by the clockwork. So Team Secret may just be happy with this. You still got a minute waiting. That's a little too long for him. At least it actually gives time for Alliance to clean up the mid lane before then looking over to Roshan. And the Observer Ward vision isn't actually perfect for Team Secret to have the fight around Roshan. A little bit too far to the north. That Octarine is done. No buyback though. Okay, if he can find some time to farm, but right now he's not really finding a lot to farm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, the big man is up, but Limp just TP'd back to base, so they got a 24-second window before Limp can return. And even then, he needs a creep wave in close, and that window is way, way too big! That's a very dead Roshan. So much damage! Yep. And you're noticing what the other items are coming up. Monkey King Bar over on the Terror Blade. The same is being built up by the Lone Druid. In fact, he's already got the Javelin on the Courier. Probably just waiting for that last little bit of money to finish the job. And in fact, he just got it. That's difficult to do. Like, the only way they're going to get that is if Team Secret are initiating on someone who's out of position. Oh boy, the perfect 32-minute rune for Team Secret. A nice double damage, and they're already pinging it out for MP. Unless they want to give it to Terrorblade. MP looks like he's hitting harder than anyone else right now. Here they come. Loader is the bait. Let's see if they take it, and yep, they do. Loader unable to get the rage off in time, and the hookshot forward. Innocent Farm couldn't do anything. The amount of damage he's taking is ridiculous. Mid one, the attack never dissipated. Vengeful Spirit gets stunned up. He'll go down as well. They're waiting in a ceremonial position for EGM, and now he'll tether up. The Ghost of Defies a little bit of time, but there's Angry Bears on the front lines, and Loader is a triple kill and die back over on him. EGM will fall as well, and that's the game. There is no way Alliance can defend against that Team Secret. Game one, it goes to the boys that everyone knows, Team Secret.